on stats subject, and we have the first paper of stats in our academic this time. So this is a problem, linear programming problems. In this problem, we have linear equations, which will be the solutions of this. We have to find the maximum value which we are getting for this problem. So to find the maximum value, we will have certain methods to solve that problem. And the first one is graphical method, second will be the simplex method, and the third will be the Big M method. As you asked me to explain the Big M method, I have taken this problem. So we can solve this problem using Big M method. For solving Big M method, we need certain rules to be followed first. First step to solve this problem is we have to see that the right side of this we call as constraints, right? This we call it as constraints, and the right side of the constraints should always be positive. If they are not positive, we have to multiply it by minus 1. Okay? Then the second step we have to observe is the symbols here. This is equal to greater than or equal to less than or equal to. And for this also we have certain rules. And first, if we have greater than or equal to sign in the equation, then we should convert it. If we have greater than or equal to sign, we should remove the surplus variable and add the artificial variable. The surplus variable is, if we have any equation like this, whenever the equation has the greater than or equal to sign, to make it equal to what the element, what the number we are removing from that or the adding that, that is called surplus variable. If we have greater than or equal to, that is called surplus variable. If we have less than or equal to, or the number which we remove or add to make that as an equation, that is called slack variable. So slack variable is not based on this Big M order, Big M method. So we only need surplus variable. So here we have greater than or equal to sign. So this equation can be changed as 4x1 plus 3x2 minus S1 plus 0 S2 plus 0 A1 plus A2, because whatever the variables we are considering, that all together from these equations should have a matrix form, basic matrix form, that is 1 0 0 1 or 1 0 0 0 1 0 or 0 0 and 1. Okay, so this first step is greater than or equal to sign. We have the greater than or equal to sign, we have to remove the surplus variable and add the artificial variable. Then coming to the next rule is, if we have equal to sign in the equation, then we should just add the artificial variable. So the first equation will be changed as 3x1 plus x2 minus 0s1 minus 0s, sorry, plus 0s2 and plus A1 plus 0 A2. See, here we have considered as A1 plus A1, 1 A1, and here we considered as A2, because if we consider this as matrix form, we will get 1 0 0 1. Okay, so we have to take that in a way that it should get a matrix form. Then the second third rule is, if we have equal to sign or greater than or equal to sign, then we should have negative cos to the objective function. This function is called as objective function. So if we have both these two signs in the equations, then we have to add the negative cos to this objective function. So this objective function will be max of z is equals to minus 2x1 minus x2 minus 0s1 negative cos plus 0s1 plus 0s2 negative cos ma1. Here we are talking about artificial variable. So we take a1 and a2, and this m will come under cost. This is negative because we have taken negative symbol, negative cost. So the next equation will be again is less than or equal to less S0 and S1 plus S2, because here why do we add this is 3 and 6. We just converted into equations by adding surplus variables and artificial variables. Now we got the equations. Now based on this, we have to form a matrix. Form a matrix. By using the coefficient, we have to form a matrix. That matrix will be 3, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. Right? And 4, 3, minus 1, 0, 0, 1. And here will be 1, 2, 0, 1. Other two will be zeros. Right? And here, what are the variables we need to write them in a column? X1, X2, S1, S2, A1, A2. Then the right side constants 3, 6, 4. To solve this problem, we have to just substitute. The next step will be we have to just substitute X1 is equals to 0, X2 is equals to 0, and even S1 is equals to 0. So if we substitute these values in these equations, we will get A1 is equals to A1, A2, S2 is equals to 3, 6, 4. See, you can observe that if we substitute these equations, these values in these equations, you will get this matrix. Now, based on this, we have to draw a table. The first one is basic variable. Then CV, the basic cost, then XP, then these will be the variables which we are having in the problem. The variables which we are having is X1, X2, S1, S2, A1, A2. And this column will be minimum of XP by XI. XI will be taken from these elements. Okay? Then whatever variables which we obtained here, those will be taken as basic variables. So A1, A2, S2. Then the cost variable, the basic cost is which we have taken in the max. So A1 coefficient is minus m, A2 coefficient is also minus m, then S2 coefficient is 0. Right? Then XP is the values which we got here. So 3, 6 and 4. Right? Then now we have to calculate the max. Max of Z is equals to, max is obtained by sum of CV and XP terms. So minus 3M plus 6M. Minus 3M minus 6M. So totally 9M. Minus 9M. Minus 9M will be the max value. And what's the main aim of this problem solving is we have to get the constraints as positive. These positive, we have to obtain here the positive elements. Till we obtain the positive elements, we have to continue this process. And so here, whatever the terms we get is the matrix values we have to write here. So 3, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 0. 4, 3, minus 1, 0, 0, 1. 1, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0. Now, what is the, these values which we write now are called as delta j's. These delta j's are obtained by multiplying CV and XP, sum of CVs and XI minus CJ's. Here we have CJ's. This is the basic cost which we have taken. That will be obtained from max of Z. So minus 2, minus 1, 0, 0, minus M, and minus M. So delta J's are obtained like this. See, if you want minus 3M plus minus 4M. So minus 3M and minus 4M, minus 7M. Minus 7M, minus 2. Sorry, plus 2. Minus of minus 2 is plus 2. So, Then after this, what we have to do is we have to know the most negative term. Most negative term is obtained by substituting n value. We can just consider the m value as 1 and check. Then the most negative term will be this. Okay? If you substitute m value, the most negative term will be this. Then, after this, we have to just find the minimum of xp and xi. So, for finding the minimum of xp and xi, first find xp by xi. For which column we have to do this is, for which that we find the minimum value, that column, this column divided by the minimum column, right? So, 3 by 3, 6 by 4, 4 by 1, and this will be 5.5. From this, the minimum value we have to take. So, the minimum value will be this, right? The minimum value is this. So, the intersection of these two will be the key element. Will be the key element. So, now what's our main aim should be is the key element, below elements and the above elements should be zero. To transfer these elements into zeros, we have to apply matrix operations. Now, to continue to the next step, this key element, we have what this key element do is, from this element, A1 will be the outgoing element and X1 will be the incoming. So, X1 and minus 2 is the CP, basic cost. A2, S2, minus M, these remain the same. These remain same. And these costs will be varied. This key element always should be 1. To make this 1, we have to multiply the divide it by same element. So 3 by 3 will be 1. 3 by 3, 1. And this will be 1 by 3. 0, 0. And this element, we no need to calculate this element. Because A1 is left from our problem now. So we can leave that A1 column. Then A2 calculates the values. Now to make these elements 0 and 0, we should now, to make this element as 0, what we should do? To make this element as 0, you multiply this row. See, this row and this row are same as it is. We just divide it by 3. So multiply this row by minus 4 and add to this row. Right? Multiply this row by minus 4 and add to this row. Then you will get the second row elements. That second row elements will be 2, 0, 5 by 3 and minus 1, 0 and this will be 1. Okay? Now this second element should also be 0. So to make this as 0, we should just see here and this one and this one. We can do that 0 by normal subtraction. So just subtract this column by this row by this row. Right? So 4 minus 1 is 3. 1 minus 1 equals 0. 5 by 3. 0. 1. And this will be 0 again. 0 minus 0. Right? The same way we have to calculate max value. Max value is again obtained by this and this multiplication and addition. Right? Minus 2 minus 2m. Right? Minus max is minus 2 minus 2m. So this will be the max value. Again we have to calculate the delta j values. Same procedure. I will just write down the values here. 0, 1 minus 5m, 5, 3m and 0. See, in this we just got m values. So, if we substitute that n value by 1, then we will know the most negative term. This will be the most negative term. Again, cv values. Sorry, xp by this most negative term, if we make, if we calculate, then you will get this like 1 by 3, right? Then you will get 3, 6 by 5, 9 by 5. Okay? From here, what's the lowest value is 6 by 5.
You guys understood, right? Okay, fine. Anyway, thank you, Gayatri. Thank you very much. Okay, bye, everybody.